Get up off of that thing. A soulful brown ale from Devil May Care Brewing in Winnipeg. Nice and malty. Just a hint of hops. Very nice beer. I've had this one before. That's not a surprise. Pretty cool thing. And you've also got to love a beer that's got a James Brown theme going on. So tonight, I thought I would tear down this janky little bug zapper thing that I got in a recent mailbag. As you may recall from that, it's got some blue LEDs in there to attract bugs and some metal work in behind the safety grating to kill the bugs when they land on it. And it's making horrible connection to my plug here. Let's see how much power this thing draws first. Oh, yeah, okay. I have to plug it in upside down, turn it on. It's drawing 15 milliamps. Pretty much nothing. Power factor of 0.06. Wow, that's horrible. It's even worse than I expected. Oh, bounced up to 0.13 for a second. Wow. So what's your guesses on this thing? Oh, hey, it held some power there. There was a capacitor charged up across that. I wasn't expecting that. Let's do that again. Okay, so it's powered on. Powered off. Disconnected. And what happens if... Not sure if you heard that or not. I heard a little tick when that happened. Didn't really see a spark though. Anyway, that makes it more intriguing. I thought it was possible that they had just wired the grill here straight to the AC mains, but apparently they haven't. There's actually something happening in there. And as we noticed during the mailbag, there is just a shadow of something rattling around in there. I had wondered if it might just be the LED power supply, but maybe it is actually creating some high voltage that it's hiding behind that safety grill. I'm still a little scared to put my hand across it, even though I have shorted it out 2 or 3 times here. Let's see what's in here underneath these 4 screws. Okay. So we're just soldered onto the power lugs there. Oh, there's one little peg that the power supply is sitting over. That is some tiny, tiny little wires in there. Obviously, there's not a lot of current going on. There is the LED board. Is that discoloration or is that a really creative solder mask? It's not really coming off. Can that be intentional? That's horrible looking. Anyway, you can sort of see the traces on the back there. It's 4 LEDs in series. TP4 LED. Okay. There we go. 2.7 volts. So essentially 3 volts. Standard blue LEDs. 369. 12 volts roughly to run that board. And what's going on here in little driver world here? Got 2 diodes. So rectifier probably. Resistor. And 3 capacitors. Let me draw that out quickly and see what's going on there. Okay, well, as expected, that didn't take too very much time. So the power comes in, goes through the switch there. From the switch goes up to the common of a bunch of things. The non-switch side comes straight through into the circuit and... That doesn't really need to be there. And it goes to the common side of this resistor and these 2 diodes. The resistor, which I didn't measure. 1K resistor? Okay. Is in series with the LEDs, which are 2 in series, 2 in series, and then in parallel with each other. So that right there is about a 6-ish volt drop. Then we've got a series capacitor with a bleeder resistor across it. Thank you very much. So it's just a very basic little capacitive dropper with no rectification. The LEDs are being their own rectification. So that's that part. Then the other two, I've got these two diodes, each being sort of a half-wave rectifier, with a capacitor in series with each one of them, and then off to the switched line. So that's these two blue capacitors here. So these two series capacitors, another sort of capacitive dropper, but not really, because these things are rectifying and the capacitors are charging up to the peak voltage of the mains, not the RMS voltage, which is about 120 volts. The peak is going to be about 170 volts. One of them's going to be charged to negative, one of them's going to be charged to positive. So 350 volts-ish. Yeah, we should be able to measure that, I think. Anyway, that's all that's in there. So I'm just going to quickly toss this thing back together to make it slightly less dangerous to plug in than it is sitting there. And I think we'll measure it. So under normal circumstances, I wouldn't recommend anybody using these meters for anything high voltage. Certainly not plugging into the mains. But I bought them specifically because they are cheap. And if I blow them up, I'm not too concerned. Okay. That's not fitting in there very well. Let's give those a little bit of a squeeze. Okay, so there we go. We have LEDs. Now then, I'm insulated over here. I'm going to use a single hand for this. When you're messing with higher voltages, you don't want to use two hands because your chest and your heart is in the middle. So here, the worst thing I'm going to do if these things arc over is just to tingle my hands. Don't try this at home! What did I predict? Pretty close to that, I think, if I remember correctly. So I assume that's going to be enough to kill your average bug that lands on this thing. Which is all it really needs to do. I'm not going to touch it. I guess there's going to be some current limiting in those capacitors, but yeah, I'm not going to touch this barehanded. Did you notice when it discharged? Yeah. Watch the LEDs carefully when I discharge it, because there is some of that pulse goes back through the LEDs just quickly. Did you see that? I'll do it one more time. Oh, and I even got a spark too. So as we saw, there are no resistors or anything to discharge these capacitors here, which is why I keep getting a zap. The dropper capacitor for the LEDs does have one, so they actually do shut off. Nifty. Not much else to say about this thing. I knew it was going to be cheap and nasty. That's part of why I bought it. Anyway, that was fun. Let's put the safety shield back on. No, that wasn't glued on. That actually fell off when I was pulling it out of where I'd stored it between the videos. I mean, it's just on pins. Yeah, don't buy this unless you want to specifically tear it apart and laugh at it like I just did. Well, thanks for stopping by just for that quick little teardown video. Like I said, I didn't buy this for any serious purpose other than just to tear it down and laugh at it. And I've done that. Thanks for watching. Talk to you later. Cheers.